Violet's gone.
Watership Down was an animated adventure film released in the year 1978. It was directed by Martin Rosen and based on the book written by Richard Adams. But I dropped out of college because I couldn't read, so let's talk about the movie instead.
All the world will be your enemy. Prince with 1,000 enemies. And whenever they catch you, they will kill you. But first, they must catch you.
The film focuses on Fiver, a young rabbit who is gifted with premonitions, who predicts a great tragedy coming down on his home, which is eventually revealed to just be humans building houses, but, you know, same thing, so.
You must listen to me, Hazel. Something very bad is going to happen.
Well, I suppose we'd better try and see the chief rabbit. You can tell him about it, but I don't expect he'll like the idea at all.
So Fiver and his brother Hazel go to see their politician who doesn't care about anyone, the Chief Rabbit, who, meh.
Now what sort of danger, I wonder?
I don't know, but it's bad. It's so bad.
Well, now, what ought we to do?
Go away, all of us, now.
Now? In May? The mating season? And where would we go to?
So much like politicians who pretend that global warming doesn't exist, he basically tells them to fuck off and ignores the problem until it bites him in the ass later in the movie. But I'm getting ahead of myself. After this, Fiver and his brother decide to gather up a group of their friends against the Chief Rabbit's wishes and go off in search of a new home. That's the basic premise of it. It's a great underdog story. Fiver's up there with Bilbo Baggins as some of my favorite adventure heroes. And, yeah, unlike most kids' movies, it uses animal characters not as a way of selling itself, but as a way of dealing with heavier, almost more disturbing and adult themes, more suitable for children, you know? If you had an animated cartoon about an adult doing their taxes, kids wouldn't watch that. But if it was about, say, a rabbit doing their taxes, you know, kids would find that ageless and timeless and... You know, in this movie, there are some violent and disturbing and depressing scenes, and I do think some of the impact is lessened by the fact that they are rabbits. But that's a good thing. That's a good thing, because this is a children's movie, after all. It deals with themes like oppression and grief and change, and it's all complemented by a beautiful soundtrack and animation. It's burning like fire. And yes, if you noticed, that was Art Garfunkel singing the song I just played of Simon and Garfunkel. He did an original song for the soundtrack, and the original score too is just great. It was composed by Angela Morley, and I really don't think you could have this movie with any other composer. It just fits the tone perfectly. There isn't much to talk about with it because it's a very simple film, and this works both for it and against it because, you know, this movie has a certain reputation, which I found out after watching it was just because of how mature it is for a kid's movie. No, but yeah, if you were ever looking for more mature themes in animation, this is definitely a movie I'd recommend for you. I gave it a 9 out of 10, and it's on HBO Max, and it's available through the Criterion Collection. And speaking of the Criterion Collection, I'm Troy Mefford, and I like this movie because I'm better than you.
Prince with 1,000 enemies. And whenever they catch you, they will kill you. But first, they must catch you. Digger, listener, runner, prince with the swift warning. Be cunning, and your people will never be destroyed.